Hi friends, myself Anand Govindaswamy, Assistant Professor at NGP Institute of Technology. So this session we will see excellent view about the panel discussion of pioneering works in cancer research. Okay, let's see different perspective, different views from our students.
Good evening friends, we are going to discuss a topic about pioneering works in cancer research. So what's cancer? Cancer is a deadly device, a deadly disease, and it has been developing abnormal cells in our body. So it can also develop into other cells inside our body, and it can also lead to death.
Cancer research has been ongoing for several centuries. In late centuries, it is very difficult to find the equipment which is used to treat cancer. But in 1950s, researchers found the equipment which is used to remove the tumor cells only. But in 1900s, radiation therapies are used.
There are generally 350 types of cancers. In our body, there are more than 3000 genes present. And among that, only 319 genes causes cancer.
Yeah, how can you tell that genes can cause cancer?
Genes can cause cancer in a way that it can be transferred through chromosomes. That is, if a parent has cancer, when the chromosomes being transferred to the child, the child also may get cancer.
Yeah, that is a thing that tobacco causes about 22% of cancers, and 50% of cancer can also cause by with a lack of exercise. And some more perspective is there. And here, the US in 1980s, US has first made the decision to work on progress by supporting many of the patients who are suffering from this cancer. And they named this as the war on cancer. This US foundation has helped many of them across the world to fight against cancer.
Yes, according to the analysis, from 2015, 90.5 million people are affected due to cancer, and 14.1 million are at the starting stage of cancer, and 8.8 million people have died due to cancer. This is a deadly disease, and the children below 15 years, 16 lakhs of children are dying due to cancer.
So nowadays, the funding is a major role. All have created awareness on cancer, so many of the trustees and institutions are voluntarily funding the cancer patients. National Center of Institute, National Cancer Institute has funded 5.2 billion, which is the highest fund throughout the world to the cancer treatment.
But in this 2000, early 2000, now it changed the funding. More than the funding agencies, now there is a lot of taxpayers and charitables are involving under funding this cancer institute.
And the scientists who are treating the cancer, they must be aware of all the physics, chemistry, biochemistry, medical physics, epidemiology, etc. They should be aware of all these basics. Not only biopsy will help to treat the cancer, but also the knowledge about all these things are necessary for the treatment of cancer.
UK government has announced the October month is the most awesome month for creating awareness among the people for the cancer, luckily we have now we are in October month, so it would be a wonderful cancer awareness discussion.
Yeah, coming to the awareness, in Coimbatore, KMCH has also arranged for a cancer awareness program for the treatment of breast cancer.
Yeah, according to the awareness, pink is the color for the beautiful color for cancer awareness. So the South African cricket team, yearly they will play in the pink jersey, and the funds which are being collected for the match would be given for the cancer institutes.
Yeah, sir, again, I also heard there is a lot of thing about this pink. There is a lot of pink ribbon used for this cancer patient awareness. And so far we are discussing about the basics and what is cancer, for the treatment, and about the funding agencies. But recently there is a technology which has emerged for the treatment of this patient who are suffering from cancer. Is anyone aware of this technology?
Yes, the scientists named James Allison and Ponzo got the Nobel Prize because they found a clinic for the treatment of cancer.
Yeah, you are absolutely right. They both got Nobel Prize for this October month. Is anyone know about the technology which is involved in this this treatment?
Yeah, I came through that. Our human body immune system was programmed for the separation of cell cells from the non-cell cells, and it is a critical response of white blood cells, generally called as T cells.
There are two types of proteins. One is for switching on cells, and the other one is for switching off cells. These are mainly called as checkpoint proteins. So, immunity, which is the major thing we need to protect from diseases, but these cancer cells reduces those immunities which can cause many other diseases in our body, and the diseases are affected easily and can be contagious too.
Yeah, Diksha, but the T cells can interact with the cell cells and can also produce a more immune response to our body, so they can also destroy the cancer cells easily.
Yes, the test for the cancer can't be done on humans, but they are done on the mammals for the first time. The treatment used for the cancer are they can be known as the gene therapy, chemotherapy, and the radiation therapy, and the targeted therapy, and the photodynamic.
Thanks for giving this wonderful opportunity for us, and thank you.